Hey, Rory, Danny Mod here. Thanks for joining us. This week, I am super excited because I have one simple move that you can do, whether you're a senior golfer, lady golfer, average amateur golfer, that will massively help you generate so much more power in your golf swing. More importantly, it will generate it in a very accurate way. Now, how do you generate power in the swing? You need to make sure that you're generating clubhead speed. How do you generate a keep those accurate? You need to make sure that when you're swinging, you're staying nice and in line and nice and centered as you're doing this. But there's one key thing that creates all of that. I'm going to share with you in this training exactly what that is. Before I do though, if you're new to the channel and this is one of your first videos, consider subscribing. Press that little bell button next to the subscribe button and you get notified every time I release a video just like this one. So, what is this magic move? Very, very simple. If you can understand how you shift the weight in the feet, it will have a direct result in your entire golf swing and the amount of power that you generate. Let me explain. So we said, look, briefly, how do you generate accuracy in a golf swing? To generate accuracy, one of the key factors is this. We want to stay nice and still in this line, but at the same time, move. We don't want to stay still and just do this. We want to be able to move in a nice spiral fashion. So we want to stay still and we want our body to move and turn, or spiral, I like to call it, backwards and forwards. With that in mind, we also want to generate club head speed. We want to then let go. So how do we create all those things? Well, if you want to stay centered whilst moving at the same time, you have to shift your weight correctly. Now imagine this. Most people don't realize what they're doing with their feet. Sometimes people don't use their feet at all. I don't know if you're the same, but if you're not using them correctly, it has a massive impact on the way this thing moves. Watch this. If your weight moves from your left to your right in a sliding fashion, as an example, look where I've moved. I've moved off the center. That's going to have an impact now on my ability to get back to strike it, accuracy. If I move off center here, that's going to have a massive impact on how I deliver the club back to the golf ball. You see a lot of amateurs, I don't know if you're the same, going forward and then they move back here. That's going to affect your strike. So being able to stay centered is huge, but just trying to stay centered like this won't generate any power. So we need the centeredness and the movement to generate the speed and the accuracy. So let me show you how we do this. What we're going to do now is this. Your weight, or any player who moves correctly, their weight on the backswing moves into the toe of the lead foot, my left foot, and into the heel of the right foot. So it kind of does this. Watch from this angle. So see how my right hip goes backwards here? I'm creating space here. I'm exaggerating here, by the way. I'm moving right up to the left foot's coming up and I'm moving into my right here, okay? Then on the way down, what happens is there's a pressure where they start to become now about 50-50 and then it goes into the heel. So the body's doing this. Because it's doing this, it's easy to stay centered. If we start to shift like this backwards and forwards, that's gonna have a huge impact clearly on your swing. So how do you go about working on this? Well, there's a couple of simple ways. Now, the first way, I've just teed a ball up here with my iron. But what I want you to do is, to make it easier just for the feelers, what you could do is this. You get yourself set, and I learned this particular drill from a guy called JJ Rev. If you've never heard of him before, check him out online. He's got some fantastic stuff. And what you do is you move your weight onto the front part of your left foot and then move it into the heel. Now, what I do to kind of really exaggerate this is actually lift the toe up of the right foot here. So it's like toe to heel, toe to heel, toe to heel. Now, this is really exaggerating it, because then what we're going to do, we're then going to go heel to toe, heel to toe, toe to heel, heel to toe. Now you're learning to shift, one, two. Now initially it sounds quite complicated, but it really isn't. You're just feeling, and you might not want to hit any golf balls initially with this. You might just want to go toe to heel, heel to toe. Just feel that motion. Now notice if you have been a sway or you've been moving around, this will feel like a completely different move. And it might feel really weird to start with. So I get a ball, that's why I teed it up. We get a ball and we start to have a go at this. So all I'm gonna do is this, I'm just gonna move. Backwards and forwards. And we're just practicing getting a sensation of that motion. And notice how centered I stay. I'm not moving this way. And the reason why I like to lift the toe up here just as a drill is because it forces you then to really get this back here, okay? Now for those of you who slice the ball, this is fantastic because watch this. As you move here, and this is going about, look at the space we've created to come down this line versus when you're here, if you're on your toes too much, this is where slicers are generally. They're moving onto their right toe very quickly in the downswing. Whereas if you're here, you're already got all this space to come down the line. So it really, really helps. Let's have another look at this. All I'm doing is I'm moving to the big toe of my lead foot into the heel of my right, and I'm practicing this simple motion, backwards and forwards. We'll go with driver in a second. So, there, there. Really, really simple. Now, I've got used this drill. It's kind of a good one for me as well. Really helps, but for you, it might just take a little bit of time to get used to. So, what I've done, I've got a couple of training aids here. I've had these for a long time. You can get these on Amazon. I'll put a link in the description below. These are just balance cushions. And they can really help, because one of the things about this game is you've got to be able to learn to feel these motions. So I like these because these balance cushions are simply full of air. I use them actually for a lot of my gym workouts. And you get yourself stood on like this, and it just gets you a sensation here of I'm a bit wobbly, okay, so I'm off balance. But what you're doing is it gives me a sensation of, all right, I get myself balanced in the middle initially, okay? And then what I'm going to do here is I could even hit golf balls, but I won't initially. And I'm gonna get the sensation now of moving into the toe of my, you can see heel, toe of my lead foot, heel of the right. And then I practice just this. Toe to heel, heel to toe. Heel to toe mean heel of left, toe of the right. And we're just, and look at look what happens to this golf swing as I make this simple motion. Watch the shape of it. Up, and then watch this. As I start to trance down, watch this. As I move to my heel, I then start to naturally release the golf club again, whilst staying very, very centered. Let's have a look at this with driver doing exactly the same thing. And then I will talk about how you then start to add. This is the accuracy move at the moment, but it also really helps to generate speed as well. So look at the same with driver. We're gonna go into the heel, back into the heel there. So, ready? Toe to heel, heel to toe. And I can really see, I call it like a scissor effect, I can really feel this changing the entire shape of the golf swing. Now, for those of you who get used to this and are slightly more advanced and wanting a little bit of knowledge about how to then start the downswing with this motion, first of all, that in itself could be a drill that you work on for a week or two, but you might pick it up really, really quickly and you've got the flow. Then you want to start saying, well, how do I generate even more power? Well, you'll see with some of the best players, they even get like this. When they've got this weight into the heel here, they get into what I call squat position here. Now, this is a feeling, again, of a real good sense of power for the best players. But it might not be something that you want to work on straight away. Work on the first stuff. But this is where, if you're really advanced and you want to push on and generate more speed, let me show you what actually happens. So we're moving into the heel. My right hip goes nice and deep here. Now watch this. As I then plant this heel down here, that stayed deep. And now I'm in this squat position, as if we're going to do a squat. Now from here, what we do is we're going to push back into that heel, and away we go. So this is like the middle bit we're doing now. We've done the two, one, two. The middle bit is where the power is you're gonna start to develop that power. So it's, you've got into that heel, now watch this. That's the squat bit, that's the power bit. Okay, now I probably do this again in just in phases. So it's heel, squat, power. So you can see from here, what we're doing is we're simply getting the sensation here, look, of that, moving to that heel, getting this nice and deep here. And then from here, that heel starts to come down. We're staying deep and then bang, we move further into that heel onto the toe. And hey presto, we get that shot. So we might want to do this nice and slowly initially. We drive a heel to heel and away we go. Keeping everything nice and slow, nice and simple. Start over, one, two, simple as that. It will really, really help you get generate the simplicity of how that swing, more importantly, how the body works and the feet work to create your golf swing. So let's summarize, what have we done? Where does power come from? Power needs to have accuracy. So to create the accuracy, we need to make sure that we stay centered in a line here. We're only moving off. How do we do that? Well, you've got to move your weight in your feet correctly. If you move your weight all over the place, that's going to shift the what's up all over the place. So it's simple action, you do this at home, heel up, toe up, and we're simply moving backwards and forwards like this. Then add the golf swing. Look at that motion there, yeah? You see that? So we're just getting that sensation. Start with that first. Then, maybe get some balance cushions. Again, I'll put a link in the description below. Get these on Amazon. They're not expensive, but they really enhance the amount of feel that you get with this entire motion. Then, if you're advanced, you may need to look at adding the squat for the really extra power, which is simply this. So you've been, if you're moving deep into that right heel there, and then from here, watch this, from this position here, you're then pushing back, you're moving into this squat position as if you're just about to do a squat, and then from there you continue the push into your heel as you move up onto this toe here, and it's as simple as that, he says. But I would start, for most of you, really simply toe to heel, really feel it, heel to toe. It will really help generate those extra yards, and more importantly those accurate yards, because it's smooth. So I hope you enjoyed the training. If you did, give it a thumbs up and maybe share it with one of your friends who could benefit from something simple like this. But of course, if you're new to the channel, maybe come and subscribe by pressing that little bell button and the subscribe button. Until next week, have a great golfing week.